Hello and welcome. My name's Allan Behrens from Taxal, and I'm joined by some very interesting guests. I think you'll agree. István Csanády from Shaper 3D. Hello, István.
Hey, Al.
And Al Dean from Develop 3D.
How are you, Alan?
Good, I'm great. And what we wanted to do today is just talk about some of the trends in the CAD industry. I think for many people, they'll have seen the industry go through these sort of phases. And certainly there's something happening. And that's why, in particular, we've got István joining us today. And just to go over what's actually happened over the recent or not so recent past, Al, in the world of CAD. Have you noticed anything?
I think there's a move towards, it's a fairly hackneyed phrase, democratization. I think access to proper digital design tools has grown. Maybe the hardware has got a little bit more accessible. And there's a lot more folks interested in creating their design data. They're moving into engineering. It's an interesting time. There's a big growth, I think.
I mean, certainly there's, you know, the world is moving to digital. I mean, István, you know, you're in the business. You know, where have you come from and what's your sort of background?
Yeah, so my background is software engineering. I graduated as a software engineer 12 years ago. And during the last years of my university, I had another CAD startup where we were working on a generative design tool with a visual programming language. Then I joined LogMeIn as a senior software engineer, and then I started Shaper 3D.
So, I mean, something certainly that I see evident in the current market, people talk about industry digitizing. And I think in the world of CAD, the world is digital, albeit there are elements of manual. I mean, there's still clay models, for example. István, have you got any observations about that?
Yeah, I mean, there is a generation that has grown up with iPhones in their hands, right? I'm in that generation too, and I agree with Al that indeed the democratization of design tools is a massive trend, but the way how we see it is that it's actually a generational shift. So as this generation that is really the first actually digital native generation has grown up, we just demand our software, even our B2B and business software, to be amazingly easy to use. We don't want to go to trainings to learn how to use these tools, and we believe that because of these needs, every software, including CAD, is going to be much more accessible. That of course unlocks a very large market by democratizing access to these design tools, but it's also going to be the mainstream of CAD as this generation is becoming the majority of the workforce.
Right. And the platforms, Al, the platforms have changed dramatically over the past 20 years, haven't they? I mean, there's just been a phase shift in how people use technology.
I think there was the idea that the CAD operator or the platform that they use was a specialist piece of equipment has maybe gone away. The idea that a much wider spread of folks can use those digital creation tools has grown, I think. Part of that's a platform shift. Part of that is the more people are used to interacting with 3D data, whether it's games, whether it's AR, whether it's VR, whether it's just the idea that 3D is present in cinema, TV, that kind of thing. There's the fear of 3D has gone away, I think. And that's causing a platform shift to more accessible tools.
I agree. And I think the other thing that's changed is there is this on-demand perception of software, especially coming from the world of mobile phones and everything. People expect to be able to time slice their life much more than in the past. So you don't just sit down at a desk and do design. You do lots of jobs, you know, perhaps during the day, maybe focusing on some for longer periods, but you expect to be able to pick something up, do it it's easy, it's fun, actually. I think there's an element of fun involved in it. And people just want to get on and do it in as pleasant a manner as possible. I don't know, István, do you find that as well?
Absolutely. Like the purchase behavior, for example, has completely changed of even of businesses. Like most businesses don't want to go through a cumbersome sales process nowadays. They just want to start using their software and maybe use a credit card to purchase it or maybe talk once, like half an hour with a salesperson to help set up things, but that's it. And so basically the old world of going through a weeks-long sales process, having a customer success manager or a salesperson sitting in your office installing your software and configuring it on your computer, it's just gone. That's not how people want to access new tools and want they want to try it immediately. They want to access all the features immediately. They want to learn it by themselves. They want to educate themselves. They don't want third parties to be involved in this early engagement process. That's really the world of the 1990s.
So that's a great segue into, so I mean, why don't you just explain your business and what you're aiming to achieve?
So at Shaper 3D, if I had to summarize in a single sentence, basically what we do is that we think a lot about what has changed in the last 30 years that allow us to create a design tool that is a much better fit for the needs of 2020. And the result of this thinking is an iPad application, a professional 3D CAD based on Parasolid and D-cubed, where we, in the first 4 years, we were exclusively focusing on reinventing the design experience for multi-touch and stylus interaction. And basically this new interaction model that we have created for Shaper 3D resulted in an amazingly easy to use, super fluid design experience that you can learn in no time, even if you have literally zero CAD experience. But if you're a CAD professional, even then you will find it a super fluid and super intuitive experience that allows you to design in a way that really feels like this is how CAD should work in 2020.
I mean, Al, you've used the application. I mean, what are your thoughts on how it's different to what else is on the market?
One of the big issues with other systems that have maybe been around a little longer is that they focus on the documentation of design. It's about rigid modeling. It's about creating a perfect form that's then taken through an engineering workflow. And I think what István's done with Shaper 3D is give folks a set of tools that let them think, but think and experiment backed up with 3D geometry, which is something that's not really been done before. It's about experimenting and actual proper design work, rather than documenting something you've already pretty much fully thought out.
Exactly, and this is what we usually say when we are explaining Shaper 3D, that CAD stands for computer-aided design, but actually traditional CAD systems are computer-aided documentation tools and not really design tools. So I totally agree with that. And we are much more focused on the design process.
Yeah, and I think the other thing, István, is the thing I certainly sense is that you certainly take advantage of some of the newer, I mean, there's a lot of people using iPads. I mean, you know, goodness me, you know, a lot of design engineers, especially the youth, got iPads, and yours is one of the bits of software that really takes advantage of that. And I think Apple endorses you as such, which is good for you.
Absolutely, we haven't. We have been one of the top iPad apps since we released Shaper 3D, and since 2016, actually, we were featured in several Apple events and Apple ads. Last year, we won an Apple Design Award, which is really the top appreciation that you can get from Apple. Only 4 or 5 applications a year get it out of the several million apps in the App Store. We are super proud of that.
So what? Okay, let's think about what's happening next. So, István, what's next for the business, and what do you see happening over the next couple of years?
So, from day one, we have been following the same strategy, and that strategy is that we have started with a conceptual design tool and an ideation tool, focusing on the first 70% of the design process, on the prototyping, ideation, sketching part of the design process. And basically what we've been doing since 2016 is that we are step-by-step adding more and more functionality to the product to cover more and more of the design process. And in the next few weeks, we are going to release drawings, engineering drawings, manufacturing drawings as a new feature in Shaper 3D that will allow us to cover a significantly bigger part of the design process.
Great, good. Al, what do you think, you know, firstly about what István has talked about and their future and what you think is going to happen in this sort of market?
I think the software market is something that's changing, and it tends to go on a 10-year cycle, I think. I think the last big shift was the move towards more cloud, but I think that's maybe a distraction. I think that's essentially the same tools running on a slightly different platform. A friend of mine described it as just running on someone else's computer. I think maybe what engineers and designers want is tools that let them be more creative in the way that they want. And it's not just about a mouse and a keyboard. It's not about being sat at a desk. It's about being out, ironically, in the world that we're in right at the moment. But once that's out of the way, things get back to normal. And there's folks that will travel the world, first off tooling in China, hop on a plane, go and see their customers in Singapore, back to the US and back home. I think we need a different set of tools for how business is done, and particularly design and engineering has maybe got left behind a little in it. There's quite small iterations of the tool sets that have been around for quite some time. Maturity is a good thing, but maybe we need something else.
I'd like to thank István, yourself and Al for your input. I think it's been a very interesting conversation, and I hope that the viewers enjoyed as well. Thank you.